Now let us see the practical transformer. So what is a practical transformer? So in the previous class we have seen ideal transformer. So ideal transformer is nothing but it is an imaginary transformer which is having zero losses. But while coming to the practical transformer, it is having some losses. It may have iron loss, copper loss and your core losses. But for ideal transformer, those are all zero and it is having infinite permeability of the core, but it is having some finite permeability. So let us see the working principle of a transformer. The basic principle on which the transformer works is a Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. It is also known as mutual induction. Mutual induction between the two coils. So what are all the coils we are having in the transformer? Primary coil and secondary coil. So the working of the transformer is, here we'll see working of the transformer. The transformer consists of two separate windings placed on a laminated silicon steel core, where here you are having laminated steel silicon core. So to this laminated silicon, on this laminated silicon steel core, here we have placed windings. This is called as primary winding and this is called as secondary winding. And to this primary winding, the AC current is, this is here we are applying voltage. V1 is a voltage which is applied to your primary winding and load is connected to secondary winding. So we can say that the winding to which the AC supply is connected is called as primary winding and to which the load is connected is called as secondary winding, which is shown in this figure. It works on, this transformer works on alternating current only, because the alternating flux is required for mutual induction between the two windings. So it means that if you apply, what happens if you apply direct current? So with the direct current, there is a constant flux is generated. With that constant flux, it is not possible to produce a mutual inductance. Induction, mutual induction is not possible with the constant flux. So for the mutual induction between the two coils, we need alternating flux only. That alternating flux is generated with only alternating current only. With the alternating current only, it is possible to generate alternating flux. So here we are applying an alternating supply. This alternating supply produces a magnetizing current, that is IM is a, this I1 is nothing but is your magnetizing current. This magnetizing current flows through this primary winding. This magnetizing current produces a flux in this core. This flux generates EMF. Here flux is produced in this core. When AC supply is given to primary winding with a voltage V1, we are applying AC supply to the primary winding with a voltage of V1. An alternating flux phi is set up in the core of the transformer. So here we are applying V1 is a voltage. Because of applying this V1 is a voltage, magnetizing current flows through the primary winding, which produces a flux in this core. This is called as a flux. So this flux is set up in the core of the transformer. This flux links with the secondary winding. As a result of it, the EMF is induced. It is called as mutual induced EMF. And the direction of induced EMF is opposite to the applied voltage V1. So this is because of Lenz law, that is shown below. So this is called as flux. This is your flux and this is your induced EMF in the E1 in the primary winding and E2 in the secondary winding. This is due to your self induction and this is due to your mutual induction. And the direction of your V1 and V2 are opposite to each other, due to your Lenz law. So physically there is no any electrical connection between the two windings, but they are magnetically connected. That's why the transformer is called as, it transfers the energy from one circuit to another circuit which are not in physical connection. And therefore the electrical power is transferred from primary circuit to the secondary circuit through the mutual induction. So you need to remember that the transformer works on electro, that is a Faraday's law, that is electromagnetic mutual induction. The induced EMF in the primary and secondary windings depends upon the rate of change of flux linkage. rate of change of fluxure linkage, that is indicated with n into d phi by dt. This is called as d phi by dt is called as rate of change of flux. D phi by dt is a change of flux, and this is same for both primary winding and secondary winding. The induced EMF E1 in the primary winding is proportional to N1, and that is of E1 is directly proportional to N1, and E2 is directly proportional to N2. So which is shown here. Here the E1 is directly proportional to number of windings, and E2 is directly proportional to number of windings in the respective section. That is of primary windings are responsible for E2 and responsible for E1, and secondary windings are responsible for E2. Let us see the transformer and DC supply. What happens if I apply a DC supply to the transformer? What happens? So I discussed above, the transformer works on AC supply and it cannot work on DC supply. If the rated DC voltage is applied across the primary winding, then what happens? A constant magnitude flux will set up in the core of the transformer, and hence there will not be any self-induced EMF generation. As for the linkage of flux with the secondary winding, there must be alternating flux required and not a constant flux. It means that only the alternating flux is responsible for mutual induction. Next, according to the Ohm's law, the current is equal to voltage by resistance. So the primary current is equal to DC voltage by, that is of resistance in the primary winding. The resistance of the primary winding is very low. What happens if it is having very low resistance? The primary current is high. If the resistance is low, the current becomes maximum. So this current is much higher than the rated full load primary winding current. So because of having this higher current, hence as a result of this, the amount of heat produced will be greater. Therefore, eddy current loss. Eddy current loss is nothing but I square into R loss will be more. So because of this, the insulation of primary winding will get burned and the transformer will get damages. So this is the reason why the primary winding will get burned, because of eddy current losses. Now let us come to turn ratio. A turn ratio, it is defined as a ratio of primary winding turns to the secondary winding turns. The turn ratio is equal to N1 by N2. And in the next class, we'll see, like, we come across with step up transformer and step down transformer. So when a transformer is set to be a step up and when a transformer is set to be a step down. So according to the number of turns, we can say that it is a step up or step down. So if number of turns in the secondary winding is greater than number of windings in the primary winding, then the transformer is said to be a step up transformer. And when a transformer is said to be a step down transformer, if N2, N1 is greater than N2, that is of, if the prime, this is your N1 is nothing but primary winding turns and N2 is secondary winding turns. So if the primary winding turns are more than the secondary winding turns, then it is said to be a step down transformer. Next one is, the last one is transformation ratio. The transformation ratio is defined as the ratio of secondary voltage to the primary voltage. Here the turns ratio is nothing but your primary to the secondary. Next, transformation ratio is nothing but your E2 by E1. E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1, which is equal to a constant value K. So as E2 is directly proportional, this is E2 is nothing but induced EMF. This induced EMF is directly proportional to N2, and induced EMF in the primary winding is directly proportional to N1. So this is all about working of transformer. So here you need to remember a key point, that key points are the working principle of a transformer is Faraday's law. And here the induced EMF direction is opposite to your applied voltage because of Lenz law. So with this, we can conclude that here we have completed your working principle of your transformer.